Thank you for joining us. This is Orbit Network Training, Section 1, Orbit Basics. Now, before we get started, I thought it would be a good idea to just review what the Solartron Metrology Orbit Network is. Basically, it is a configurable modular measurement system for Solartron sensors as well as third-party sensors that outputs into PCs and PLCs. It was first released in 1995. We are now on its third generation, and it is built on a robust industrial network where you can network up to 200 sensors. And each Solartron sensor on the network is fully calibrated at the factory in the UK. So with the Orbit Network, you can go from the simplest applications, such as a simple A plus B measurement you see here, to something much more complex. For example, this is a gauge from Landau out in Windsor, Ontario, Canada. Now for Section 1, Orbit Basics, this will be divided into five parts. Part A will be just a quick overview in terms of all the different components of the Orbit Network and how they function. Then Part B, we start diving into details about the Orbit module and building an Orbit stack, including will be mounting and accessories, discussion of inline plugs, as well as indicator lamps that are on top of the module. Part C will be choosing an interface module, and this will include discussion on basic orbit operation, as well as read modes and network speeds. In Part D, we will discuss modules that connect to third-party sensors. In Part E, we will finish off with choosing a power supply interface module, which is what powers the Orbit stack. Now, there are other Orbit training sections as well. Section 2 will be connecting Orbit to software. This will include the Orbit library as well as updating and programming examples. Section 3 will be connecting to a protocol interface module to a PLC. Section 4 will be connecting to Solartron wireless products, such as the Wii gauge like you see there. It should be noted too, there's already training on several other components of the Orbit network. For example, the Orbit GCS software. This is a package built exclusively for the Solartron Orbit network. There is online training for this. There's also online training for the Excel add-in software. This is a package where you can take readings from the Orbit network and output them directly to an Excel spreadsheet. Then there's also training for a digital input-output module. For all of these, you can click on the link on the upper right-hand side or just go to solartronmetrology.com. So first in Part A, we're going to give a quick overview in terms of how Solartron functions and all its different components. Now for building an Orbit network, you have two key components to start. You have the probe interface electronics or PI module. And then you have the T connector. And the T connector is what you use to daisy chain all the modules together. And each module typically has a sensor. Then you choose an interface module, whether it be to output to a PC, a PLC, or a readout. In addition, Solartron provides modules that will connect to third-party sensors. And in fact, we have quite a wide variety. So for example, we have an analog interface module for any type of sensor that outputs 4 to 20 milliamp or a DC output, as well as an encoder interface module that outputs anything with a square wave or a TTL output. We also have specialized modules for connecting to air gauging, as well as a module that will connect to our wireless sensors, such as our Wii gauges. And then once you have built your Orbit stack, you need to power it with the power supply interface module. This is something you place on the end of the Orbit stack. So let's get started with the basics, the Orbit module itself. At Solartron, we actually like to call this the probe interface electronics or PI module. And for each digital probe, it has a PI module that is mounted at the end of the cable. At the Solartron factory, a probe is actually calibrated with the PI. Then inside the PI itself is the calibration data as well as the error mapping data. This is an example of the calibration surface it goes through. Now, coming out of this module is not an analog signal that you need to translate. No, it is a numerical value. So therefore, there's no need for calibration of these digital probes in the field. In addition, when you receive a digital probe, it actually has a calibration certificate like what you see here. Now, once calibrated, the probe should continue to fall within the probe specifications listed in the data sheets throughout the life of the probe. Now, some of our probes have lasted hundreds of millions of cycles while retaining their repeatability. It should be noted, though, that every application is different. Customers can often check the calibration against block gauges or some other type of master part. We rarely get a probe returned for recalibration, but if the customer so chooses, we do offer that service. It should be noted that the Solartron digital probes should be kept away from magnets and electromagnetic fields. The probe is an inductive technology and can be affected by those types of fields. Our next component is the T-connector, which is what we also call the T-con. Now, this is basically the daisy chain connector that you can use to connect up to 200 sensors on an orbit stack, like what you see here. So here's an example of building an orbit stack. So next, we're just going to open a basic orbit box to show you the types of parts and accessories that you get. First, of course, you'll get the probe and the orbit module, standard T connector, but you're going to have some accessories as well. For example, that's a network terminator, some end brackets, some screws, and some mounting feet. We're going to show you how these are used in a second. So the most common way orbit is mounted is on a DIN rail. So first thing, of course, you do is take the module, mount it to the T connector, and snap it on. There's only one way you can mount it. Then you can easily snap it onto a DIN rail like so. Then for further modules and T-cons, you could just stack them alongside as well as lock it in. But a second option, though, is if you don't have a DIN rail, is to mount it straight onto a metal plate or similar. So here, first you remove the bottom part of the T-connector by unscrewing it. Then it easily snaps off. Now on the bottom, you do have some threads, and you can use those for mounting if you choose. But the more common way is to take the two plastic feet that are provided in the box and then slip them on each side. You can then mount them directly to a plate using two screws. Now, in the event that perhaps there's a lot of vibration in the area or perhaps the orbit stack has to be grounded, that's where the accessories come into play. First, you're going to want to take two screws and mount them to the end of the T-con like show, and then take one of these end brackets. Once you have that aligned, you can then mount that end plate onto the DIN rail to kind of clamp it down, as shown here. Then you can take a network terminator, plug that into the end, and screw that into the screws that you just placed in there. Please make sure to tighten them. You also have this option if you mount it directly onto the plate, as shown on the picture. So now we will discuss some optional inline connectors that you can have for your orbit probes. So while most customers typically use a probe that is hardwired to a Pi module, we do have an option where you can have an inline connector. And this connector can be plugged directly into the module, like what you see on the left-hand side there, or it could also be inline along the cable. Now, one thing that should be noted is between these two configurations is that for the standard orbit probe, the hardwired orbit probe, you know, the calibration data for the probe is stored inside the module. And this configuration will still give you the highest performance for a digital probe. But for inline, the calibration data is actually stored inside a chip that is mounted inside the connector itself. So when you plug the connector into the module reads the calibration data and then functions normally. So These types of inline connector probes are most ideal for applications where a probe is damaged frequently, or if perhaps you want it easier to install the probe on a complex gauge. It should be noted too that it is a lower cost to replace just the probe and the connector. Also, the inline connections have the same resolution and repeatability as the standard hardwired probes. But it should be noted that this type of configuration, it is available for most standard Solartron digital products, but it's not available for all Solartron sensors. Please contact your local Solartron representative for information. The next section will be about the indicator lamps that you see on top of the Orbit module. These red and blue lamps are used to indicate power, signal transmission, as well as if there is a hardware failure. So now the blue lamps typically indicate that readings are being sent. So they will either be solid, on like this, or blinking, which means one command is being sent at a time. Now, if you have a red lamp with a slow blink, that means there is not enough power being sent to the modules, and you might have to add a power supply interface module. This is an example of a stack that's perfectly powered, but then when you add too many modules, the slow blinks come on. Now, if you have a red light flashing rapidly or is permanently on, that means you could have a hardware failure or a probe failure. When detaching an inline plug, you're also going to get a solid red light as well. When you reattach it or attach a new one, you might have to actually detach the module or perhaps restart the system. So for indicator lamps, this is just a general chart showing what the blue and the red are. But it should be noted for some of the specialized modules, especially for the ones that connect to third-party sensors, the indicator lamps might have different purposes. For that, you will want to consult with the manual. So this concludes parts A and B of the Orbit Basics training. For parts C and D, please click the I in the corner, or if you are watching this on the playlist on the Solartron YouTube channel, that should start momentarily. Thank you.